floor is yours, Mr. Homans.
Thank you.
Your Honor, the unfortunate position that we find ourselves in here for this trial is that the Board of Commissioners, based upon the allegations that we believe will be proven from the evidence presented, failed to honor its duty to adopt a budget for Sheriff Johnson that is reasonable and adequate to provide for the personnel and equipment to allow him to perform his duties as sheriff, which requires him to enforce the law and preserve the peace under the Constitution and statutes of Georgia. We submit that the Board of Commissioners, the evidence is going to show, failed to honor this obligation imposed by law, primarily, Judge, because they relied upon incorrect information in adopting this 2018 budget. And what the evidence is going to show is that what the, this is in, it'll be in one of our exhibits, Judge, but as we go through, let me try to turn this so maybe there we go. Judge, what this is going to become a focus, and if I can pull it out a little bit, I went the wrong way. What it's going to show is that this was presented by our commission chairman, Mr. Thurmond. And under the law, Judge, it's a little bit unusual in Dawson County. Evidence is going to show under our enacting legislation, the chairman presents the budget as opposed to the county manager or the chief financial officer of the county. So the chairman has the duty and obligation to present the budget to be considered by the Board of Commissioners for approval. And Mr. Thurmond set about to do that, and the evidence will show that on August the 10th of 2017, when he was presenting for the Board of Commissioners for the 2018 budget, which is the issue that brings us here, that the chairman showed $7,334,486 is what he was proposing for 18. This is the number that will become significant, Judge. What was relied upon by the Board of Commissioners in showing what fiscal year 2017 was is $6,822,566. The reason that will be significant, Your Honor, is that the evidence here will show that in 2017, the Board of Commissioners approved a budget that set aside at that time $350,000 for salary increases for 17. Now, I'm not talking about 18, for 17, but it wasn't categorized. It wasn't set aside for a specific department or a specific office. The evidence will also show that the Board of Commissioners came back in April of 2017 and they amended that 17 budget. And they added $374,440.42 for salary increases, rendering that a grand total of $724,440.42. At that time, Judge, of necessity, the evidence will show that increased this 17 budget by department. And when you add that increase, because the evidence will be the Sheriff's Department has roughly 50% of the employees impacted by that salary increase, based upon numbers that the county puts out in various reports, which would render the increase to the Sheriff's Department budget in fiscal year 2017 would increase this number by approximately $362,000. So the Board of Commissioners went forward to adopt a budget believing that the change in the budget was 7.5%. The evidence will be that that increase was substantially lower in somewhere between 2 and 2.5%, and that the budget amendments were in April of 2017, and the budget was put together throughout May, June, and July, and then the chairman presented this. So there was sufficient time to calculate that budget amendment and make sure they were relying upon correct information when adopting this budget, because the sheriff's critical need will be people. He needs staff. He's insufficiently staffed. Furthermore, unfortunately for the Board of Commissioners in trying to render their decision and exercise their discretion, they filed a verified answer for us, Judge. And what that answer shows, I just want you to see this number of $9,173,800. In their answer, county says total approved budget for FY18 was $9,173,800. Judge, and I also want to explain that we expect the evidence throughout this trial to show that the way a budget is put together here in Dawson County can create some confusion, because what the chairman had put in and what we discussed during the budget hearings, the chairman did not include SPLOST money, capital project money, or E911. He addressed those separately outside the sheriff's budget. In other county budget documents, the evidence will be that those items were included. So you're going to see a wild variation in numbers, but I believe that'll be explained during the hearing and the trial, that it depends upon whether you include E911 or whether you include capital project items in the sheriff's budget. But you'll see, I'm emphasizing this number 9173080, because our belief is the evidence is going to show that this is another document that's part of the exhibits, that where the county erred, let's see if I can get to this, Judge. This, I'm going to scroll back up, Judge, but this $600,000, the evidence is going to show that that's SPLOST 6 money. And unfortunately for the Board of Commissioners, this is the county's approved budget document. When we do the math, when we put up the witnesses, the evidence is going to show that included in that $9,173,080 is that SPLOST money of $600,000. And the county's verified answer says that the sheriff has discretion to move that money around. That's what they believe. But that's not the law. And we'll argue the law at the appropriate time, but they just relied upon incorrect information. As I've told you, Judge, the evidence here is going to be the sheriff's critical need is people. You now have as an exhibit what the sheriff says he needs. And I'll have to get better with this machine or come back to it, but that's the overall exhibit I want you to see. You will have, and it's in your budget book, and Mr. Hallsworth will be here to testify from the Georgia Sheriff's Association, that in year 2015, according to Mr. Hallsworth's study, Dawson County Board of Commissioners should have funded 139 positions for the Dawson County Sheriff's Office. The evidence will be that the Sheriff's Office is the only law enforcement agency in this county. But that's a little bit unusual for our area. Most other counties have either a city law enforcement agency or multiple city law enforcement agencies, and or university police or another law enforcement agency to assist in preserving the peace and enforcing the law. For 2018, I'll have to turn it, Judge, and I know that's hard to read, but I want you to see what I'm doing there. What the sheriff came in and said was these positions were frozen years and years ago, and he's asking that these positions be unfrozen and that one position be added. So he's saying I have 112 positions now, and I want to go to 122, and that's the bare minimum, because to get to 15, I would need 139. Evidence will be Dawson County has exploded with growth since 2015. All you have to do is drive up 400 and look at the Kroger Center and the public center that have opened since then, and the sheriff will offer testimony about the growth in population and permits, and we'll have testimony about the increased number of calls, but it's just common sense. But I go back to this because the evidence will be that the county manager of Dawson County has seen fit to issue press releases and establish a public relations campaign with one of the local press groups, and has asserted on more than one occasion that the sheriff of Dawson County complains that we don't have enough patrol, but we didn't even ask for patrol. Now, he told that to the press, but he won't talk with the sheriff, and they won't talk with me, because the evidence will be that out of these positions, it will be patrol. The evidence will be, and had anybody asked, the sheriff would have told them, accreditation manager was the name of the position when it was frozen. That is a patrol position. The canine sergeant is on time, will be added to patrol for Dawson County. The SRO that the commissioners approved with the assistance of the Board of Education, and they also removed money they had previously allocated for a SWAT team or for equipment for SWAT team to fund it. But that position provides patrol. So the Board of Commissioners, based upon those press releases, believe what was stated, that he's not adding any patrol, but the evidence will be that if these positions are awarded, he will have patrol. And the evidence will be that what the sheriff was trying to do was get to this 2015 staffing analysis so that he could have sufficient positions to enforce the law and preserve the peace here in Dawson County. And so to slice those positions and just award one a school resource officer prevents him from doing his duty. The division commander is going to testify, Judge. The sheriff is going to testify. Mr. Hallsworth is going to testify about the impact of not having these divisions and these staff, the divisions fully staffed the way that they should be. And it frankly, Judge, will, we submit, indicate the dangerous situation that's placed for these officers and for the public. I'll let the division commanders go in, and frankly, Judge, we're going to ask them questions that just let them testify. But the examples will be that in the investigations division, the investigators, they don't assign to a specific type of crime because they don't have sufficient personnel to do that. The evidence will be that we don't even have an evidence custodian officer assigned full-time to do that job. Instead, one of our detectives has to spend about 30% of his time doing the evidence custodian work as well as all the other work he needs to do. And as a result of that, for example, on the drug surveillance, the commander of the investigators is going to testify that they're unable to do proper surveillance. They just don't have the necessary personnel. The evidence is going to be that when there's a major crime, because they're not specifically assigned, they've got to pull everybody off of whatever other investigations they're doing to investigate a child molestation or some other major crime. And oddly, Judge, the evidence is going to be that as a result of the budget assigned by the commission, they don't even have any administrative assistants over there. So as a result of that, each detective is having to prepare their own report. They're responsible for providing that over to the district attorney's office and doing all the other items that they should be able to assign to an administrative assistant. And that prevents them from enforcing the law and preserving the peace. It prevents them from getting the bad guys off the street in the investigations division. In the patrol division, the evidence is going to be that they really don't patrol, Judge. All they do, I believe his phrase is going to be, we're call takers. And so that means that they get a call, that they run to another call, as soon as it's finished, they've got to go to another. And they're unable to perform that patrol division, and that leads to a higher traffic fatality rate and other serious injuries. In the court services division, they oversee warrants. The highlight, Judge, I submit there as a result of not having a sufficient number of officers is there are hundreds of criminal warrants waiting to be served. because those officers have to provide the court security and the other duties, and they generally have to send two officers out, and so it's a matter of getting the time where they can send the two officers out to serve warrants. In the detention center, the evidence will be we don't meet standards. Again, and by standards, I mean the Sheriff's Association provides standards, there's national standards, and that we're unable to meet those. Again, the Board of Commissioners relied upon incorrect information because we submit the evidence that's going to show that they believe, that is, the Board of Commissioners believe, if your inmate population goes down, therefore you ought to have fewer people needed in your detention center. You'll hear from the sheriff, you'll hear from Mr. Hallsworth, you'll hear from our detention center commander or the assistant that will tell you that's not the case. That in order to properly run a detention center, you've got to have a minimum number of personnel serving that role. Our E911 director will be here to testify as to any statistics that may be challenged, but in general, the evidence is going to be those call volumes are going up. There's one item, Judge, in here that we submit further shows that the commissioners have abused their discretion. On the budget,
sorry, I had it with me, Judge.
On the budget, the evidence is going to be this $260,000 that's labeled here on this budget summary exhibit has been placed into a capital project fund. And you may know this, Judge, but I need to make sure it's in the record. A computer-aided dispatch system is what the sheriff put in his budget book under capital projects. That's one of the items he put. And in the budget book, it's going to show that the cost currently, or at least when he presented it, was over $500,000 to get an entirely new computer-aided dispatch system. And what that does is it allows the call, well, you know this, but it allows the calls to come in and then the radio can dispatch out to the emergency, including the sheriff, but EMS, ambulances, so that they can understand and be safe when they're going about their business. But this item was placed into this capital project fund with restrictions. This 260 was placed in here with restrictions, and it's beyond the sheriff's discretion. In other words, the sheriff can't move that around the way it was approved in the budget, that it's just set aside. And as opposed to considering any sort of lease purchase option, any considering using SPLOST funds for this 260 to free this up so that he can provide staffing, which is his critical need for manpower, the Board of Commissioners set this item here saying, okay, well, next year we'll add to it. Well, we don't know what the cost will be next year. And also to place that, to isolate that to within the sheriff's budget when it improves the performance of all emergency, we submit shows an abuse of discretion. The sheriff will also testify that as a result and all of his division commanders, because of the limited staff that they have, they're having to work more overtime, and that they're unable to have meetings, pre-shift meetings. I call it the old NYPD meetings, where the NYPD TV show used to begin where they were having the staff meetings. They can't do that at Dawson County Sheriff's Office. People are working overtime, and also because when they come in, they don't have sufficient budget to work that in for that little 30-minute review. But that's critical, Judge, and I'll tell you why it's all critical. We submit that at the end of the presentation, we will have established that the Board of Commissioners have abused their discretion. We don't submit that they've abused their discretion necessarily, although it may be that there's some personality issue or there's some other issue. But the evidence will be that the information was there, but they just relied on different and incorrect information in setting this budget. And for those reasons, we're going to request that you issue a writ that allows the sheriff's office to properly perform their duties and requires the Board of Commissioners to provide a budget for him to do that. Thank you.
Your Honor, I've reserved my opening until the commencement of our portion of the case tomorrow or later today, whatever that may be.
That'll be fine. Let me ask, so I make sure I understand what it is you want. What I'd like is, what are you asking me to do? You want me to sign an order that says what for the petitioner?
Judge, I think all that the law permits you to do is to issue a writ requiring the Board of Commissioners to issue and provide a budget to Sheriff Johnson that's sufficient to allow him to perform his duties. And we submit that the budget they've issued does not do that.
But it would be not numbers, but what you're saying is just simply, we need what we want is a new budget that includes furnishing part or all these items.
Yes, sir. I think that's all the law permits you to do. I don't think the law allows you to say you've got to award X amount.
I think you're right. Mr. Fry, what do you say? What do you want?
I believe he is correct about that. The law does not contemplate putting the burden on the Superior Court judge of becoming a budget officer and forming the budget, whether it's one he requests or otherwise. I think the way you just characterized it is if you should find in favor of the request for mandamus, it would be something along those lines.
Okay. All right.